So Brian and I here getting ready to put in. We are getting ready to put in here confluence of the new river. So we go down here straight across. You have the South Fork New River, I believe, and this way is the North Fork New River. Conjoins right here, exactly where we are for the new river. So with that, we were off. It was the beginning of a 41-mile journey over the next 3 days. Today, we would encounter few rapids. However, a little over 7 miles in, we would have a dam to contend with. The plan was simple: portage the dam and look for camp shortly after. For now, though, it was time to see what the new river had in store for us.
Thank you. Brian's gotta get out of his boat.
There's just a rock garden, pebble rocks.
Too low to get through.
He couldn't get over to the right quick enough.
See him back there?
That was pretty cool.
The water level overall was pretty low, but there was definitely enough flow to make it through and not have to worry too much about your lines. There were enough rapids to keep us interested. They weren't too big, but they were still fun. The outside temperatures were in the low 80s. For the middle of July, I wasn't going to complain. The water felt cool and refreshing. One thing was for sure, this was setting up to be a good trip. We have some slack water, about a mile of slack water till we reach the dam. The dam went into portage on the right. At least that's all the information I have.
You want to get out here and go look?
Oh, shit. I'm gonna fall, I know it. Oh crap, I don't even know how I got to here. I can check so both of us don't get out. Have to get out unless we both have to.
So if you look real quick, that's the takeout.
Walking back here to Brian, and this deer came out from right in front of me. I startled it, and it scared the crap out of me. It was hilarious. Unfortunately, I wasn't rolling the camera at that very moment. But yeah, excitement everywhere we turn. So as you saw up there, I found the takeout. It's thin, it looks like it's gonna be tricky, but it beats carrying these kayaks this far. I think it's doable. You can tell that it's the takeout that a lot of people use. So I think it's the better option. We took some time to check out the dam, and from an angle, not many do. Portage was easy. It was only about 200 feet, maybe a little more. We were able to drag our kayaks most of the way, and at the end, we had to go down an embankment, which wasn't difficult. Overall, it was probably the easiest portage I've done. We took one final look above at the dam, and now it was time to find a campsite.
Watch out for the cows.
Huh?
Watch out for the cows.
Oh.
I'm chilling in the middle of the river.
Okay.
Well, if I want some more, I know where to come. We came across an island that looked promising. In fact, we decided to go 100% all the way around the island looking for a campsite. So that island didn't work. There was just too much brush. But we found something up ahead that would do just fine.
decided to make this our campsite. Little island, there's a couple places where we can get some hammocks in, and it's not quite as overgrown as some other places. I'm attempting now to see if I want to cut these trees down so I can get across easier. Tell you what, this little saw works pretty darn good. Look at this.
So this island was small, but it was fantastic. Good hammock trees? Check. Not overgrown too much? Check. A great pebble beach? Check. The sound of running water? Check. A small amount of bugs? Check. A great place for a fire and a great swimming area? Check. This island may have been a small one, but it was a good one.
So I'm sitting here at the fire, making my steaks. Fire going, Brian's swimming. I'll probably take a swim after dinner, but we do hear and see the sound of thunder. Well, we don't see thunder, we hear it. Hopefully the cell stays away from us.
So day one was in the books, and it could not have gone better. It was time to enjoy the fire and the evening, because tomorrow we would get back at it.